Alright, come on in. Welcome to my house. My boy Riley decided that we needed to do a vlog for the day that my day gets started. Come on, Blanco. But, yeah, this is... Welcome to my house. 6 o'clock. Well, it's actually like 5:45, 5:50. We're getting the day started. Getting everything situated with... The day kind of progressed throughout the day. We're going to be able to show you guys a little bit of the insights of what I do every day. Obviously, taking my pre-workout to get this workout started. It's leg day. So, gotta get the energy just back up. I wake up every morning at 5 a.m. Why? Because it's actually the best time for me personally in my business and what I do to wake up at 5. It allows me to get my workout done by 6 o'clock in the morning. I'm working out, and for me, I have to shower every morning. I have to get ready every morning. It's not that I just get up, throw on gym clothes, and go straight to the gym. So I get up, I wake up, I read my daily devotional. I read some inspirational stuff that's gonna get me through the day. And then obviously I meditate and pray. And then I jump in the shower, listen to a little bit of music while I'm doing that. And then, of course, get dressed, and then we're off to the gym. But before the gym, obviously, we have to get some pre-workout. First Form, Project One, probably one of the best pre-workouts in the market. Obviously, you can find them on all self-made training facilities and such, but that's one. And then, so what we do for leg day, I kind of have already in my head kind of what I'm gonna be doing for legs. But it's not an actual strict program. Basically, I just pick a body part a day, and I pick four different exercises to five different exercises, and then I get just straight to it. So when I get there is when I'll figure out exactly what I'm doing. And I should have used a shaker cup, but instead I used a glass of water. Sit. I know you're excited. Sit. Sit. Good boy. Stay right there. Okay, sit. Hey, good boy. You gotta sit. Hey, sit. Blanco, sit. I know you're on camera. You're excited. I know. No, hey, don't jump. Hey, sit. Sit. Good boy. Stay. Lay down. No, sit. Lay down. Lay down. Lay down. That's not all the way down. Okay, back. Good boy. This is my boy. He's 8 years old. Blanco's been with us since he's, you know, pretty much 8 weeks. Yeah, 12 weeks when he was born. No, 8 weeks. Got him from New York City. When I found him online, I was very specific. I want an all-white blue-nosed pit. And they're super rare. They don't come often. And I emailed the breeder, hey, make sure he's all white. No spots or nothing. I want all white. He says, oh yeah, he's fine. So of course all the videos he sends me are all the front, sides, and he's still a baby, so you can't really see. But when he got here, and we picked him up from the airport in San Diego with the family, he had a spot. So he's not all white. Huh, Bongo? But we fell in love with him. Oh, tell him. Talk to him. Talk to him. Say hello. Say good morning. Say good morning. Another daily ritual that I do every day, no matter what, right, is I make my bed. That's one of the most important things you can do in the morning. Hey Google, turn off the music. So, making your bed is probably the most important part of your day. Why? You actually accomplished and completed something. So if you accomplish something every day and you complete something every day, things will happen. Right? When I get home from a long day at work, knowing that my bed's done, it's not another task I have to do when I get home. And it's another thing too, is you walk in, it's like that pride of ownership, pride of, hey, this is my domain, this is my home. And this is where you spend at least 6 hours out of the day sleeping, right? So you need to make sure that you understand, especially you young entrepreneurs, you young people out there. You wake up, get up, and your bed and your room's a mess. What does that tell you? Same thing with your cars. You're gonna go into my car right now. You can go into your car, and if it's a mess, that's a reflection of who you are in your business. It's a reflection of who you are as a person. So you guys gotta understand, the little things amount to big, big, big things. So always, always. You're always gonna find my house spotless. You're always gonna find my house with my bed made. And even from my closet, color coordinated, everything. Why? It's the attention to detail. You do the attention to detail through so those small little things, the bigger things will come. Trust me on that one. I know I say, trust me is not a good word to use, especially if you don't know me, but understand this. If you want something similar to what I have, you gotta mimic it. You don't have to copy it, you have to mimic it. If I'm telling you, if you're an entrepreneur in the fitness space or in the real estate space, waking up at 5 o'clock in the morning is gonna do you good. Why? From 5 to 8, those are 3 valuable hours that you can get a lot accomplished for yourself, and then yet prepare yourself for the day. So when you're working from 8 to 7 p.m. or whatever that number is, right? You can tackle every task because guess what? You took care of yourself first. So at that point, take that, note it, make sure you guys use it. You guys wanna check out a cool little car? It's 1962 Impala. I just picked this one up not too long ago, as you guys follow me through social media. This 1962 ragtop has an LS2 in it, fully decked out, low-ridered out. This one's gonna get completely renovated and done. If you guys know me, I love cars, I love automotive, I love motorcycles, anything with a motor, boats, anything, I'm all about it, guys. It's what kind of motivates me to do more. Not only does my family motivate me, but the things that I love, you know, motivate me to wake up every day at 5 and get shit done. All right, so Larry, my equipment manager, if you guys don't know, I own Collusion Fitness Products. So what I do is I created a separate company that we sell all our gym equipment to all our franchises and other locations as well. So any gym, if you ever want to open up a gym or want equipment for your home, let me know, because I actually own Collusion Fitness Products, which a lot of people don't know. But we're going to start expanding that company here shortly, but primarily our main focus is supplying all our franchises. But my boy, my dude, my right-hand man, Larry, he just got done installing our cage. We'll go over there and check it out in a little bit. But as you can see, this company, it's a daily thing. It's 24 hours a day sometimes. These guys have been working since 9 p.m. last night. But the value that I want to let you guys know, the main reason I've had huge success in the last 2.5-3 years, especially 3 years, is I've been able to delegate. You know, I used to be a real control freak. I used to try to control my whole environment. But at the end of the day, it takes a strong team, my family, to get this business to go where it needs to go. So delegating to being able to create these other platforms and also provide employment for other people has been a huge blessing in many, many ways. What's up? This is a young cat right here, Odessa. He's gonna come do leg workout with us this morning. Future real estate agent over at Self Made Real Estate. He's gonna be doing his license. Yet again, as much as we want to let our audience know and people out there know, is that you gotta bring other people with you. You know, between Riley, the camera guy, behind me, my marketing director and marketing manager, and also building and helping me build this empire through social media. And then obviously Odessa, I met him through Riley. He's gonna be joining my team as a real estate agent. When I see a young individual that can, you know, do anything that they wanna do and I can advise them to get into real estate, I'm gonna highly advise them. Why? Because it dramatically changed my life. So you gotta share that with people. I can't give somebody something, but I can give them the knowledge, my time, and everything else that comes with it, because at the end of the day, I don't know what his success is gonna be. Is he gonna kill in real estate? My goal is to say yes, but it's gonna end up on him, not me. All right, let's get this fucking leg done. They ain't gonna work themselves. It's like 5 in the morning, still working, still spitting. I'm still up in the streets trying to hustle up a million. Then it's back to the booth, spit a whole ball of chili. That's hot, real hot. It's like 5 in the morning, I'm still working, I'm still spitting. I'm still up in the streets trying to hustle up a million. Then it's back to the booth, spit a whole ball of chili. That's hot, real hot. I call the salsa doozers and pastas trying to jack me. Doing it and doing it, homie, don't get your ass beat. This my time to shine, we go live for live. Got a couple killers on the team, they die for mine. What's up, homie? My name Tony. Alright, killed legs. Got a nice little pump. I'll come back around 10 a.m. to do jiu-jitsu. Open mat with Chuck Pant here at Temecula. And I'll be able to get my cardio in that way. I always try to do something different for cardio. I don't like just doing the Stairmaster. I don't like, hey.
What's crack?
Have you guys met my boy Frank, the OG? Frank, Third Strike Athletics, huh, bro?
What's up, guys?
What's up? Tell him what's up. Say hi to the camera, bro.
Hi, camera.
Frank's been with me since day one, huh, Frank?
Yes, sir.
Like, how long were we open when you first got to the first location?
Two weeks. All right, boys.
2 weeks, huh?
2 weeks.
Yeah, we didn't even have all the gym equipment in, huh?
No.
What a trip. He's been with me since then. It's like 4 years? No, 5 years, dog. Damn. We're getting old, huh, bro?
Dude,
but hey, like anything, us men, we age gracefully, dude.
I'm just getting started.
Yeah, bro. We just getting warmed up.
42 years old, fucking just getting started. Boom.
All right. Another good, successful morning. Got it done, got it in. It's a good way to start the morning, a good workout to start the morning. Because what's gonna happen is obviously you're gonna start your day on a positive note. So if we can recap, right, slightly. Start by getting up, meditating, praying, reading a devotional, a self-help book, something that's gonna get that mind right. Don't go straight to your phone in the mornings. I've been doing that for the last couple months and it's been amazing. I don't go straight to Instagram, I don't go straight to Facebook or my emails. I get up, pick up my book, get that 30 minutes in to kind of get the body and the mind right. And then from there, do my daily prayer and meditation, jump in the shower, ideally a cold shower, wake your ass up, get your vitamins in, get your pre-workout. I work out on an empty stomach, but I eat a heavy, heavy, heavy dinner with a good amount of carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. So when I wake up, I'm fully good, still get a solid, solid pump. And then from there, get here by 6 a.m., get my workouts, and I'm able to get it done in 45 minutes to an hour. I'll be home by 7:15, 7:20, shower again, get ready for the day, and then I got the rest of the day to handle all business. And with business, it's really not really a set schedule of every hour accounted in the sense of detailed timeline. But what we do is we basically conquer every task that was left from the day before. Any additional tasks or appointments that I have, those are set by the hour. And then from there, I finish off my day with my second workout. But we will get that later today. All right, buddy. You guys want to meet my boy Jason Shirley?
Oh, snap. Hold on. What y'all doing, man? Y'all trying to get my good side? Hold on. It's my other side. This is the good side.
My boy Jason's been with us for how long now, dog?
Almost 2 years. Be 2 years Halloween.
Damn.
Time flies, man.
Time flies, huh?
Time flies, bro.
But I've seen this man grow in his business dramatically. But not only that, spiritually and just emotionally, mentally. Super focused. And all it took is how many conversations?
A lot of conversations. We still talking about
still
it, man.
Growing, but super proud of this dude. Ex-NFL player, killing it here at Self-Made Training Facility. If you're looking for youth, football, or just all around health, Jason will take care of you. That's, you know, the beautiful thing about owning this Self-Made Training Facility and the training facilities that we own is I interact with thousands of people, right? And every one of them is super special in their own way. They have their gift. And it's my responsibility as their leader, you know, is to see those gifts that they have and add fuel to them. Not change them, not, you know, manipulate them to do things that they're not comfortable doing. It's really getting them to understand who they are, what they're about, what their vision is, and how clear that vision needs to be. You know, I sat with Jason a few times and gave him my time. That's one thing I love doing is giving my time. I won't give you money. I won't cut you breaks where you need breaks in the sense of things kind of like, how can I put it? Like enabling them, right? I want to see them succeed, and sometimes you have to bring out the good in them because they have it. There's no doubt about it. Every human being, I've said it before, there's not one human on this earth that is so evil they have no good in them, and so good they have no evil in them. And what I mean by that is being able to balance those things out. We all are human. We all sin by nature. We all understand that we're not perfect. If anything, we're perfectly imperfect. But if I can see the value in their gifts, how can I pull that from them? How can I get them to see that and make it into fruition to actually do something with it? We're all talented. We all have gifts. We all have things that we can do with our lives. And it may not be money, it may be time, maybe be entrepreneurship, maybe being, you know, a husband, a father, all that stuff. And I'll elaborate as time goes on. There's gonna be more, another chapter to my story, you know, when it comes to my personal life. Right now I'm keeping that somewhat private, but I'm gonna share down the road of the failures as a father and the triumphs as a father, the failures as a husband and the triumphs as a husband, because in all reality, you want authentic, I'll give you authentic when the time is right. There's things in life that sometimes you need to keep to yourself and then with your God, you know, and be, or your higher power, and understand clarity of who you are, what you're about, what makes you Miguel Aguilar, what makes you you, right? And that clarity and that moment of silence and that, you know, blocking out all that noise, you really get to find out that self-awareness, who you are, who you're yet to be, who you want to become. And from there, we'll make sure that we update you guys on that as well when the time is right. Alright guys, I hope you guys enjoyed my day. Well, actually my morning. That's my morning ritual. I highly suggest you guys get a ritual yourself. Become a habit of doing something productive and positive every morning. Be made or be molded.